Arlington, Texas, 10 years ago, to the exact day, Dave Aranda got the most unsettling news. He'd lost his job. On December 4, 2011, Hawai'i forced coach Greg McMackin to resign and dismiss the entire staff, which included a little-known defensive coordinator who had 3 children under the age of 6, a take-off wife and, for the most part, an empty bank account. The previous year, with the family in such financial distress, the Arandas moved out of their small apartment and into an even tinier place, a school-controlled university housing unit meant for professors. When you were fired, you were evicted. We had 30 days to get out, Aranda recalls. Every coach has a low point in their career, when they toy with thoughts of exiting the industry, when they question their ability. This was Dave Aranda's. He remembers pacing around that apartment eating bowls of ramen noodles and drinking pots of coffee each day because it was all he could afford. It was a sad sight, he says. A bad deal. If that was the low point, exactly one decade later, Saturday is the high point. Aranda on a mobile stage situated on AT&T Stadium's artificial turf, embracing the Big 12 championship trophy. His Baylor Bears celebrating a 21-16 win over Oklahoma State, a stunning 11-2 season in the 45. Aranda, right, lifts the Big 12 trophy with his players. Kevin Jairaj / USA Today Sports. We sometimes get caught up in sports, yours truly included, writing about the touchdowns and the field goals, or the salaries and the facilities. We don't spend enough time writing about the people that make this thing so great, the ones who rise from the bottom and get to the top. Dave Aranda is one of those people. His meteoric rise, in the gutter 10 years ago and in the spotlight today, is what makes college football great. It's what makes our country great, that a Mexican-American who didn't grow up around money, fired and evicted a decade ago, can ascend to this position, as one of the most elite, highest paid coaches in America.